Hey guys, what's going on? Today we're going to be doing the event overview and team building or best linking buddy guide for the free-to-play units from the event for It's Super Saiyan Goku or False Super Saiyan Goku. So if you don't know the story from the, and this is all recollection off the top of my head, Goku in Lord Slug was supposed to go Super Saiyan, but they didn't have the actual design, so he went False Super Saiyan. He did not get False Super Saiyan here, but it does look like they kind of almost, they gave him the Kaioken, they tried to make it like Kaioken, but he didn't actually go Kaioken. It's supposed to be like a lead up to the movie that, or the series when he went Kaioken on Namek. Anyway. This is the event. Life is peaceful on Earth when suddenly a mysterious invader, Slug, appears. Slug has declared his intention to Terra Freeze the Earth to take control of mankind by covering the sky with dark clouds, blocking out the sunlight. In order to save Earth, the evil ambition of Slug, Goku and his friends must rise up. So this event is pretty cool. I know a lot of you have been waiting for Lord Slug. I already had comments from when I posted up my other video about how much you were excited about Lord Slug. I think it's awesome. I'm not a big fan of him myself, but I thought it was... I like the Team 4-star mix of it. I thought that was pretty damn awesome. But anyway, level 1, Shadow Approaching Earth. You go up against all these guys. Bring your AoEs if you have any AoEs, like your nukers, like LR Broly, OG Broly, Majin Vegeta, anything that can hit everything on the field. More than one unit, that would be awesome. You go over there, you can go and get the Flappy Wings Gohan Kid. He is a farmable unit. We're going to talk about him in this video. Level 2, Star That Has Closed the Light, is going to be where you get your Lord Slug. He feeds into the pullable, summonable physical Lord Slug before you Doken Awaken him. So make sure you do not Doken Awaken the Lord Slug before you start feeding these guys into him. Definitely grind these out. Definitely worth it. Level 3, if you guys are lacking Senzu Beans, there's a whole bunch of Senzu Beans on level 3, definitely go ahead and do that. Level 4, Goku, is where you get your Kaioken Goku. The Kaioken Goku will feed into or increase the super attacks of the other Kaioken Gokus. I believe there's only two in the game right now. That is the agility one, and there is another one. I forgot which one it was. It's from the World Tournament, though. I think it was the physical Feet Kamehameha. No, that wasn't Feet Kamehameha. It was physical, though. Physical Kaioken Goku, Ki Orb Manipulator. We'll talk about that in a minute anyway. Level 5, Evil Namekian Warrior. This is where you're going to get your Lord Slug medals. And level 6, Super Namek Warrior versus Power of Friendship. This is where you get your Goku medals. Characters of the Namekian category increase the chance of extra drops. We'll talk about that in a minute. Clear all stages on Normal and Z-Hard for training items. Clear stage 2 20 times on Z-Hard. With at least 3 cards from Namekian Saga category, you get a Dragonstone. Stage 6 on Z-Hard 10 times, 3 cards from Namekian category, you get 1 Dragonstone. And then you get a whole bunch of other character drops. Clear Stage 2 up to 15 times for a bunch of Lord Slugs. Stage 4, 15 times for a bunch of Gokus. Defeat 20, 40, 60 Slug Troopers for Hercules statues. I'm just going to say this. Defeat 500 Slug Troopers and you get a Elder Kai, Grand Elder Kai, Elder Kai Medal, Supreme Kai Medal, SSR Platinum Hercules Statue, and a whole bunch of Awakening Medals. So go ahead and do that. Pretty cool event. It's going to be awesome. I haven't played it myself. I don't even know if I'm going to play it on the JP side. We'll have to wait and see. Maybe I'll play it for some Dragonstones if we get some rewards and everything like that. Anyway, the first one we're going to talk about is the Budding Evil Power Slug. This is going to be the farmable slug that you get from the actual banner. He increases the super attack, again, as I said, of the physical Lord Slug that you could summon on the current banner that's out. Budding Evil Power Slug, leader ability, Namekian category, key plus 3, HP plus 70%, attack and defense plus 50%. Super attack, Darkness, Twin Star, supreme damage to the enemy and lowers defense. Passive skill, Eternal Youth, attack and defense plus 50%, recovers 30% HP when HP is 30% or below. So again, you have another really good free-to-play tech unit for HP recovery. I mean, honestly, guys, at this point, I don't really need to say this, but the tech teams for Prime Battle is just OP. You can do it against any freaking Prime Battle that comes along right now, unless they have a newer one that comes out. But the Frieza one and the Goku one, definitely really easy with these units that you have. Link skills are Namekians, Nightmare, Metamorphosis, Big Bad Bosses, and Brutal Beatdown. Meh, it's alright. Categories are Movie Bosses and Namekian. Max stats are HP of 8208, Attack of 6215, and Defense of 4689, 12 key multiplier of 135%. Now, as it just stands, I would not recommend increasing the super attacks of him because he is a free-to-play unit. But a lot of you guys just like doing that anyway, so if you're going to do it, go right ahead. I'm not going to tell you what the stats are, just read them right there on the screen. Or go shout out to the wiki, come over to the wiki and check out him right here. Or go to dbz.space and shout out to dbz.space and you can check him out over there. Anyway, That's him. He's an alright unit. His best linking buddy is going to be himself. So there you go. Actually, so one reason why you will want to farm this guy out is because he will link with his giant variant. The guy who Doken Awakens, the SSR who will Doken Awaken from the new Doken event, they link for 5 link skills together. You definitely want these two together. Now, with that being said, the TUR, the physical one, I already talked about this in the video that dropped on Tuesday. He has his SSR variant will link with him, so you're probably gonna want to do that over the tech one, but I would probably only recommend doing that if after you've at least done his bottom right dupe path. But anyway, if you only pulled one of him, run the tech one alongside of him. They have 10% HP regeneration when they're linked together. Big bad bosses is going to be when HP is, well, you know, attack and defense plus 25% when HP is under 80%. They have Thirst for Conquest and Nightmare. So they do have some really good link skills together. Outside of that, they have a whole bunch. It's 3 or more link skills. There's a lot of units over here. The LR Freeze is going to be a good one. You're probably never going to run them two together. You have the Baby Vegeta Super Baby 2. Transform, Big Bad Bosses, Thirst for Conquest. You have the Physical Korra Transformation, Big Bad Bosses, or Metamorphosis, Big Bad Bosses, and Thirst for Conquest. The Strength Janemba Transform, or Metamorphosis, Big Bad Bosses, and Nightmare. And then you have the Tech Turles, which is Big Bad Bosses, Thirst for Conquest, and Nightmare. So you have a lot of different options that you could run here for his best linking buddies in game. Again, the best one's probably going to be this one over here. For best attack buffs, it's going to be Turles, and you could do any type of mixture. I probably think Super Baby Vegeta and Korra and Janemba are going to be your best bets just because they're really OP units as they are. So up to you on how you want to run them. Again, this is going to be more for an extreme type team if you just happen to not have any really good tech unit to run on an extreme type team. Anyway, the next one is going to be a mono tech by itself because he is a tech unit. For a mono tech team, he really doesn't have that many people that he links very well with. I mean, look at this. I had to go down to 2 to actually get people on the board over here. So the Tech Korra for 3 or more, Metamorphosis, Big Bad Bosses, and Thirst for Conquest, and the Turles, which we already talked about. These 2 are going to be the best. The Korra, attack plus 90%, but his stats are really old. His attack is going to be 8107. So it's his super is 150%, it looks like, according to Dokkan Battle Builder. So it's not horrible, but I mean, I guess it's all right. He's not horrible. Supreme damage, and that's pretty much it. Attack plus 90% is not a bad idea. So bad to have on a team. Other than that, I mean, 2 or more, I guess the LR Rosen, Zamasu, Nightmare, and Big Bad Bosses. The Tech King Piccolo, Evil King Piccolo, Thirst for Conquest, and Nightmare, and Merge Zamasu is going to be... I know Nightmare's on there. I think it was with Big Bad Bosses. So, yeah, that's what you have. Not really that many. I'd probably go with either Korra or Turles, most likely Turles. Turles is also really good. Set for 7 turns, key plus 3, attack and defense plus 60%. Really up to you on how you want to run it. In terms of Namek Saga, I mean, really, honestly, there's not that many you could link with. I already showed, as I'm showing you here, he doesn't have that many people he links with as it is. The Piccolo, the Evil King Piccolo, is one I already talked about too, and the other Lord Slug is going to be his other, and that's just who he's going to link with. Everyone else is just one link skill. It really kind of sucks, but that's all you have. And I'm pretty sure Nightmare, Big Bad Bosses, Namekian, and Namekian. So that's about it. So these 2 are for Namekian, these 2 are just some other links. So I mean, honestly, unless you have this guy, Namekian team is only going to be beneficial for you for this specific event. Plus, I think the Namekian team for this event is the only time that it's actually used, except for maybe the Prime Battle with Frieza. Next one we're going to move over to is the Amplified Friendship Goku Kaioken. So his leader ability is Pure Saiyan's category, key plus 3, HP, key plus 2 through. Key plus 2, HP, attack, and defense plus 20%. Super attack is Kamehameha, raises attack, and it causes extreme damage to the enemy. Passive skill, Piccolo's Thoughts, attack plus 30%, an additional key plus 2, attack and defense plus 40% when HP is 70% or below. So that's not horrible. I don't like the 70% or below, I feel like it should be higher, but whatever, it's not bad. He's not going to do a lot of damage for sure at all. Extreme damage with 30% attack modifier, and you have to get below 70% for that to go through, but when he does, it's 70%, but I'm not a big fan of him. Link skills are all in the family, Saiyan Lineage, Kamehameha, Shocking Speed, and Over in a Flash. He's part of the Pure Saiyans category. The thing is, he doesn't even have Prepared for Battle, which I kind of wish he did have, because then he could at least be a Key Link Magnet. He only has Shocking Speed and Over in a Flash, which isn't horrible, but at least all the other Kaiokens have the ability to link very, very well in terms of generating Key. And max stats are going to be HP of 62, 85, attack of 77, 46, and defense of 39, 23 with a 12 key multiplier of 130%. His raises attack plus 30% is a 30% attack boost. He will Dokkenwaken with 20 medals of his own medals, which we already talked about from the actual event. Dokkenwakens into combined prowess of Symmetry, Goku, Kaioken, leader abilities, pure Saiyans category, key plus 2, HP attack and defense plus 30%. I mean, that's really not a great leader ability, but if you're just looking to run it for like another event and you don't have the actual pure Saiyan category lead like I don't, then it's going to be pretty cool to run for specific events if you need it for extra drops. Super attack, Kaioken attack, brightly raises attack, causes extreme damage, passive skill, Piccolo's power, attack plus 40%, and additional key plus 3, attack and defense plus 50% when HP 70% or below. They should have at least increased that to 80% or taken off the modifier and kept the attack and defense the same. I feel like that would have been a little bit better, but whatever, you can't do anything with it. It's a free-to-play card. Link skills are all in the family, Saiyan Lineage, Z Fighter, Shocking Speed, Over and Flash, and Shattering the Limit. So at least gets Shattering the Limit added there. That's pretty awesome. He has a whole bunch of key links. Category is still pure Saiyans. Max stats are HP of 69, 55, attack of 82, 60, and defense of 43, 23. 12 key multipliers 140% and greatly raises attack is a 50% buff. Again, overall, not really that amazing of a unit, but he is there. He will, he can increase the super attack of other Kaioken Gokus. Let's go over to the Goku disambiguation really quick. And Kaioken, there you go. So, actually, that's the Angel Kaioken. Why are you not searching properly? So, for Kaioken Goku, it looks like, okay, so we have the Tech Kaioken Goku. We have the Agility Kaioken Goku. We already know about the Strength one. So, wait, we're actually missing an Intelligence one. That'll probably be the next Kaioken. So I didn't even realize that this tech one was Kaioken. I don't even remember when this guy came out. He comes from Rare Summons. Oh, he came out with the third year anniversary. That's right. I didn't realize he was Kaioken. That's awesome. So he will increase this one super attack free to play. Now you guys know on Global when the third year anniversary comes around, do not increase his super attack if you like him with Elder Kai's. Wait, I don't think any of you would, but you can. So wait. the OGOOG Agility Kaioken Goku can increase his super attack finally. I will have to reverse doken him. He's a pretty awesome unit. He doesn't really do anything, but he's just because he's OOG. It's pretty awesome. This is going to be the trump card Kaioken that I talked about earlier in the video. He is a key orb manipulator, strength to rainbow. If you guys have been following me, you know my favorite key orb manipulators are type to type. The second one would be type to rainbow. I do not like rainbow to type at all. I personally don't like rainbow to type. Rainbow can help you out way too much, so removing rainbows is horrible. I personally don't run them, but the type to rainbow isn't as bad. But yeah, he is there, so you can increase that one. And then you have obviously the strength one, which we just talked about, which will increase all of them. So go ahead and do that. In terms of team building, best linking buddies in game, this is Son Goku, which is really just, he's kind of there. No one's ever going to really run him, honestly. I don't think so. I think, let's see, Saiyan Intuition, only once attack and defense up 120%, HP is 10% or less remaining becomes, okay, yeah. He's not that great. The hybrid Gohan is going to be your hybrid Saiyan leader, Gohan, Ultimate Gohan. He has the Sun Family, Z Warriors for attack and defense buff, and then 3 key. The Intelligence Goku card, because I'm pretty sure he has the, oh wow, nothing but key there. So he has Shattered in the Limit, Over in a Flash, Shocking Speed, and Saiyan Blood, or Saiyan Lineage. And then the free-to-play EZA Gohan from the JP side only as of right now. You get the Gohan with the Son Goku link with defense plus 15%, Saiyan Blood, Z-Wars, and Shattering the Limit. Really not that great. I guess the Gohan could be cool. I mean, these two are free-to-play, the two strength ones, the Gohan and the Kaioken Goku, so they can link together for like Prime Battle if you're running a strength team. Outside of that, I mean, I guess the Gohan's cool because you give him 3 key, and then he hits Z Warrior, which not a lot of people do, and the Sun Family for that defensive buff. In terms of, I guess this is Saiyans, or no, it's Mono Strength teams. We already talked about the Ultimate Gohan. We talked about the Gohan, the regular Gohan, the free-to-play Gohan. You have the LR Thousand Day Goku for 3 link skills with Sun Family, Saiyan Blood, and Z Warrior. You have the free-to-play Pan, which is the Sun Family, Saiyan Blood, and Shattering Limit. And the, World Tournament Gohan, which is whack, is the Sun Family, Saiyan Blood, and Shattering the Limit. Really not that great. Honestly, I think that these two are probably going to be the best ones to link with him if you're running him on a team, but I don't think you're ever going to run him on any of these teams. I personally don't like the unit that much. On a pure Saiyan team, it looks like he's just going to be alongside of the Gokus. We already talked about these three. There's no reason to really actually talk about them. You have the final Kamehameha, or the final instant transmission Goku, which is Sun Family Z Warrior Shattering the Limit. It looks like we have the GT Goku, Super Saiyan 2 GT Goku, Sun Family, Saiyan Blood, and Shattering the Limit. The Sun Goku over here, Sun Goku Family, Saiyan Blood, Shattering the Limit, and then you have the physical Goku over here for three link skills for 4 ki and defense plus 15%. Not really that great. Again, I'm not a big fan of the card, but he is there with all those guys to link with. Out of all of these, I'm probably going to go with a 1000-day Goku to link with him, and that's going to be about it. Next one is going to be Flappy Wings Gohan Kid. Okay. They should have maybe made it like Baby Gohan. I don't know. Leader ability is going to be Hybrid Saiyans, category Ki plus 2, HP, attack, and defense plus 30%. His super attack, Ismisenko, causes extreme damage to the enemy and lowers attack. Passive skill, High-Pitched Whistle. Damage received minus 30% and all allies attack plus 20%. Honestly, for a free-to-play unit, he's not that bad of a support unit. He doesn't give Ki, but at least he'll be reducing damage. Total, overall. It's not like even type, it's just damage received reduced minus 30%. So that's really awesome. Link skills are the Innocent Saiyan Warrior Race, All in the Family, the Saiyan Lineage, and Z Fighters. Categories are Hybrid Saiyans. That's really about it. Stats are HP of 74-62, attack of 68-41, and defense of 42-79. 12 key multiplier of 130%. Now, one thing about this Gohan, which is really cool, let's go over here and talk about it real quick, because I feel like I have to mention it. He does feed into other Gohan kids, which is over here. So it looks like, I mean, if you want to, I don't know how well it's going to work. You can increase the super attack of this Gohan kid. I think it's going to be like 5% chance to increase the super attack. If you Z Awaken him to an ultra rare, you might get more like a 30% chance to increase the super attack. If you already didn't use Elder Kai's. I mean, you already have this Gohan kid over here, which is farmable, so it doesn't really matter. But I figured, let me mention it anyway. You have the Namek Saga Gohan kid, which is really good support physical super unit. You have the Tech Gohan kid, which is another good unit over here. He is the HP regeneration, and you have this SR, which I'm never going to really use. But that's really about it. But you do have Gohan kids, which will increase the super attack. You don't really need to, again, because you have the Easy A Gohan, but I think because you have the category which get more drops out of it, you might be able to utilize him a little bit better than this one. Anyway, in terms of best linking buddies, three or more, there's way too many to even talk about. Essentially all the base form Gokus, pretty much all the base form Gokus over here. You have this Goku, three link skills, which is Battle Ethic Saiyan, Sun Family, and Z Warrior. The strength one that's just dropped is Sun Family, Saiyan Warrior, or Saiyan Blood, and Z Warrior. The monkey looking Goku, which is Sun Family, Saiyan Blood, Z Warrior, looks like the one he was going to train with Bubbles when he thought Bubbles was King Kai. LR Goku, which I already talked about, and then the other Spirit Bomb Goku, not the LR, the TUR, not the TUR variant of him, though, which is kind of funny because it confused everyone when it first came out. Battle Ethic Saiyan, Sun Family, and Z Warriors. I mean, again, really not that many people link with him. I don't even know why you would try. I guess you're going to use him as a leader ability because you don't have Ultimate Gohan and you want a full Hybrid Saiyan team. You have Sun Family, Saiyan Blood, Z Warrior. You have the Physical Pen over here, which you can link with him. Physical Pen is a good support unit. Three link skills, the Innocence, Sun Family, and Saiyan Blood. The Pan B, which is a free to play, the Innocence, Sun Family, Saiyan Blood, and then the Gotenks TUR, Innocence, Saiyan, Battle Ethic Saiyan, and Saiyan Blood. Not really that great. In terms of mono intelligence, it looks like the TUR Gohan over here is going to be someone to link with. I didn't translate that to English. You have the Raditz over here as well. Raditz is going to be two link skills, Battle Ethic Saiyan, Saiyan Blood, Ultimate Gohan, which is going to be two link skills as well, which is Battle Ethic Saiyan, Saiyan Blood. Then you have this Goku over here, who is going to be Battle Ethic Saiyan, Z-Warrior, and then the Goku Jr., another free-to-play, Sun Family, and Saiyan Blood. The Gohan, I didn't actually tell you the link skills. Link skills are Saiyan Blood and Z-Warrior. Again, nothing really that fantastic over here. I guess in terms of a team building guide, if you really want to do like a team building with Hybrid Saiyans, they're already on all of them, so I'm not going to really have to say anything too much. I guess you could put him with Pan, if you really want to. Or you could put one of the two Pans, essentially. That's all it really is to it. It's going to be one of the two Pans or the Ultimate Gohan. But if you had Ultimate Gohan, you probably wouldn't be running him as a leader. So that's why I didn't really say anything about that. You have this Gotenks and you have the two Pans. They could all be run together, by the way. All three of these could be run on the same team if you really want to. But that's about it. I don't really think there's anything else to say about this. Free-to-play units, you're really not going to really run too much with them unless you're doing a prime battle, or unless you were doing, I don't know, something else, like looking for drop rates or something like that for a specific event. But anyway, guys, that's it. Those are the new units. I'm not really impressed with any of them. The only one that I think is going to be the most viable is going to be this Budding Evil Power Slug, just because he links with his physical partner the best. And chances of you running a physical one, while you probably do it because of the hype, you're probably not going to do it too often anyway. So get him to Super Attack 10 at least, you know, with all four dupe pads, because you don't need to Doken Awaken him to get him to SSR. So at least get all four dupe pads at Super Attack 10. Don't increase his super attack. You never know, though, if he gets a Doken Awakening one day, recovers 30% HP when HP is 30% or below, can turn to 40%, or when HP is 40% or below, and that passive from attack and defense was 50%, who knows, can go up to 80%, you know what I mean? So keep that in mind. He might get a Doken Awakening in the future, we don't know, but I would highly recommend, out of all of these guys, get him set up, because you're going to use him mostly. And if you want to get your Gokus or Kid Gohans, you can grind them out to increase the super attacks of the other guys. But anyway, guys, that's it. Thank you for joining me here today. I hope that was helpful and informative. I know this isn't really an exciting video because it's a free-to-play event, but it's here for you, so if you want to use it. But anyway, guys, thank you. I'll catch you down in the comments below. You have a good one. Peace.